Part of what makes Longmire such a unique show is the Native American component. And getting the nuances of that world right would be very difficult to do without our technical advisor, Marcus Red Thunder.
I feel Marcus is doing an exceptional job because what he sees and what he lives, he portrays it on Longmire. So he can't get any closer to the real deal.
He represents the Indians in a good way.
My name is Marcus Red Thunder. I'm Ojibwe, but I'm Northern Cheyenne by osmosis.
I was born in Great Falls, but when I was six, my mom died of cirrhosis, so I was sent to Cheyenne home.
I grew up with Northern Cheyennes, learning about their ways, their humor. It's just a beautiful way of life and the way they brought me in. The way that we portray natives in Longmire is very authentic and real, the same as it is on the res.
When you look at the history of American Indian people, we are beautiful, vibrant, amazing culture, but also a culture that has dealt with so much trauma, so much despair.
Quite often in Longmire, Henry Standing Bear is the person a lot of people turn to for guidance. And not everyone knows that Craig Johnson, who wrote the Longmire books, based the character of Henry on Marcus.
When they told me that Lou Diamond Phillips was going to be playing the role of Henry Standing Bear, I was excited about it.
As soon as I knew I was going to do the pilot, it was very, very important, you know, to me, to meet the man who inspired the character of Henry Standing Bear. The Native American community is so underrepresented on television, and many times when it is, it's stereotypical, and our producers and writers, they want to get it right. They want to replicate the kind of respect and honor that, you know, that Craig Johnson has brought to the characters in his books.
I strive to bring current issues to the scenes. And the more awareness that we can bring to that, and the more discussion we can bring to that, the better. So when you take a look at a Longmire episode, take for example, Dog Soldier. They talk about these Indian children being taken away from homes and put in foster homes. It's true, and it happens, because there's more money given to the people that take care of them than non-natives.
Marcus, he walks the line between Cheyenne Entertainment and Cheyenne Mystery.
One thing people ask is, you know, what are Indian people going to think of this? And you have this kind of catch-22 situation. You make it too accurate, they're going to be mad at you. If you make it too far away from what it is in reality, they're also going to be mad at you.
Our ceremonies are sacred and they should be held that way. I think about it as artwork, as a painter would paint a picture of a ceremony. Like the scene where Longmire was actually fasting and was pierced to a pole. It's just an example of what would happen, but there's no way that I'm gonna show the actual ceremony. That belongs to the people.
Marcus does an awesome job.
I'm really looking forward to where we're gonna go.
This season, Marcus flew down powwow dancers, drummers, and actual pageant princesses for our Miss Cheyenne episode. Beauty pageants will never be the same. These powwows and these Native American pageants are really looking to see how well these women know their culture and represent their culture.
A powwow is a place to go where you can leave your troubles aside.
We love being Indian by dancing and singing.
Dancing is my way of praying.
I am a jingle dress dancer. It's a healing dance.
We're thinking about the people in our lives that are sick, the people in our lives that are hurting.
Being a princess to me means representing my people. That's when I feel alive.
I want to be motivation for other young mothers to go out and do their best.
Powwow brings families together, and it continues our tradition and brings pride to our people.
The drum was given to us by the creator.
To have the real drum with the real drummers, the real singer, it will allow the audience to really feel what it's like to be home.
Everything revolves around that drum.
The drum beat is the life of the powwow.
It's the heartbeat.
You wouldn't have a powwow without a drum.
These girls that I'm bringing down are all champion dancers. They've all been princesses. Their regalia is authentic. They exemplify what a true princess in a pageant would be.
I would want them to judge me on what I know about my culture, what I know about my people, what I know about myself.
You're not parading yourself around in bathing suits.
The ideas for our outfits will come in dreams or just, you know, an idea popping into your head.
People are looking at you for direction. That's why you're there.
You know, it's tough around here on the reservation. But just for a little bit while he's watching somebody dance and hearing that drum, they forget about all of that.
The way that Marcus advises for Longmire is like a steady beat.
He is like the drum, you know. They say when you hit that drum, it's like thunder.
The drum connects people and empowers you.
He's a leader amongst his people.
If you stop feeding your fire, then the world becomes dim.
And he never misses a beat.
As long as that beat is still going, our people are still going.
I've never seen this kind of care, you know, put into an episode of a television series. Storytelling is everything to our people.
This is not just a typical cowboy and Indian story.
These are stories that should be told.